today, I'm going to start the process of creating my giraffe sculpture. I'm going to begin by using a pencil and writing my name on the back of my paper. I'm going to flip my paper over and using my pizza box with the triangle pointing sideways, just at a diagonal, I'm going to trace the shape of the pizza box. So that way I know where to paint my colors for my background. Once you have traced the shape, make sure you leave a little space at the top though, and don't put it too close to the top, but you do want to put it in the top third portion of your paper. Okay, so now let's draw the neck. I'm going to draw my neck at a diagonal. You want it to kind of be on one side of the corner and on the other side of the corner. So draw that line going to the corner. I think I made it a little too skinny at the top there, so I'm gonna see if I can't maybe fix that real quick. I think the bottom part's good, but I think the top needs to be a little bit wider, so I'm going to fix that very quickly. If you make a mistake, remember, you can always fix it. There's always a way to fix our mistakes. So now I'm gonna start the process of painting. I have chosen orange and magenta for my giraffe colors. I'm going to paint orange in the background. When you are painting, make sure you are always painting in the same direction. Paint all the way to the edge of the paper and paint right along the edge of that pencil line for the giraffe's neck. For the neck, you want to paint right along the edge of the line. Now for the shape of the head, you actually want to make that orange go into that space just a little bit, because we're going to be gluing the pizza box on top of there, and we want to make sure we overlap the orange just a little bit into the space, so that way we know it's covered and we don't have any white spots showing underneath of the giraffe's head. I am now going to use magenta to paint the neck. Again, make sure you're always painting in the same direction. If you switch directions, it looks sloppy. So make sure you're painting in the same direction, whether it's side to side or at a diagonal, always paint in the same direction. For the neck, make sure you paint right up to the edge of the orange or the color that you have chosen for your background. You want to make sure you paint right along the edge. If the colors mix a little bit, that's okay, but try to touch them, don't mix them. And paint all the way to the edge of the paper. Make sure that placemat is underneath of your painting so that way the paint doesn't get on the table. And I'm going to make sure that line is nice and smooth and all the parts of the neck are painted evenly, and I'm going to smooth it out a little bit, those paint lines. I'm going to try to smooth them out some, and I'm going to make sure I overlap that magenta into the space for the head, just like I did with the orange. Now I'm going to set this to the side and I'm going to get my pizza box again. Now I'm going to use the same color I used for the neck, so that's going to be magenta, and I'm going to paint the entire pizza box. Make sure you're doing this on your placemat, because you're going to overlap that paint onto the placemat. Don't overlap it onto the table. That's going to make a big mess for me to have to clean up. So make sure you're painting on top of your placemat. Paint all the way around. Now the pizza box, it might have some wrinkles and little folds on the corners, so make sure you really check those. Now my finger is going to have to get a little messy today. I'm going to use it to hold it in place, and then after I'm done, I'm gonna pick up my finger and I'm gonna fix that spot right there where I was touching. Okay, so now I've got everything painted in. Now we're gonna glue it into our picture. So I'm gonna bring my picture back over. Let's see, let's rotate this a little bit so we can see what we're doing. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna take my glue bottle and on the inside, just barely on the inside of the line, not on top of the line, but just to the inside of the line, almost on top of it, I'm going to put a line of glue. I'm going to put some glue there, just like that. Now, I'm going to pick up my pizza box, and I am going to set it on top of that glue. Okay, so, some spots stuck, some spots didn't. I'm going to use my paintbrush to, nope, not my finger, because my finger is going to leave spots. So let's use my paintbrush. Oh yeah, that's better. Okay, so I'm going to use my paintbrush to kind of paint and press it down onto the paper so that way it's stuck. Now the good thing is, if you miss a spot with the glue and the glue is kind of sticking out, it'll dry clear and the paint will help glue it together. When you're all done, clean up your materials and put everything away.